Hello, good afternoon, and welcome to the final session in our Trendsoft user group event. My name is Bobby Haggard, and I'm one of the consultants here at Trendsoft. Let's first make sure that everyone is logged into the correct session. You've tuned into this session titled What's New in Business Central, Release Wave 1, 2022. In this session, we will be covering many of the latest features, capabilities, and enhancements coming out of this latest major release from Microsoft. Now, a little bit of housekeeping notes before we jump in. First up, we went ahead and muted all of the phone lines to try and keep down on some of that background noise. If you have a question, which we absolutely encourage, please use the Q&A feature of the Zoom webinar tool. We have a couple of teammates who will be monitoring those questions as they come in, and we'll look to answer some of those live throughout the presentation, and others we may save for the Q&A at the end. Now, if you have a question after the event, feel free to reach out to any one of your Trendsoft contacts. Secondly, if you would like the presentation slides or the video recording, just drop your email into the Q&A and we'll provide you with the info as soon as it becomes available. Finally, don't forget at the conclusion of this session, you will receive an evaluation. If you fill out that evaluation, you'll be registered for one of our giveaways, which we'll announce the winners of early next week. All right, as you saw upon registration for this user group, there are a couple of other sessions as noted here. If you missed our morning session about Dynamics GP or our lunch session about IT security, don't worry, we've recorded those and we'll be happy to post those once they become available and let you know. Now, before we get started, let's quickly hit on who we are as Trendsoft, as I can see that there are a couple of new to Trendsoft names on the attendee list. So Trendsoft was founded in 1996, and we've since achieved the highest level of Microsoft certification available, being recognized as a gold certified Microsoft ERP partner. In the last several years, we've been recognized by Accounting Today as one of the top 100 value-added resellers, or VARs, within the industry. Currently have about 200 or so active clients in 17, 18, 19 states. And throughout our 25 plus years of existence, we've been able to create and develop some pretty structured processes for installations and projects that have helped our clients to be more efficient by saving them time, money, and other resources along the way. We are experts in Microsoft's business platform, and we do all things related to ERP installations, project management, general support, upgrades and migrations, customizations, reporting, online learning databases, automation, integration, and much, much more. Now, when you partner with Trendsoft, we provide access to an online support database with training courses and our online Jira support desk and much, much more. Now, in talking about automation and integration, I wanted to quickly mention our sister company, Trendocs. As you see here, they specialize in automating the full procure-to-pay cycle. Trendocs team can assist with anything from requisitions, the payables and workflows, to payment automation. Now, if your team is not already using a portion or all of the services Trendocs has to offer throughout the P2P cycle, then listed here are 10 reasons of maybe why your organization should consider using the accounts payable automation solution. Now, I don't plan to go through all of these. However, I did want to hit on a couple of the big ones. First, the biggest benefit of Trendocs is their flexibility. Their tagline is automation as unique as you. A few other reasons that jump out is that Trendocs can offer three-way PO matching. Trendocs helps with ERP licensing needs. And finally, they offer free and unlimited transactions and documents, so there's no caps and no transaction fees. If you're interested in learning more about Trendocs, let me know and I'll be happy to make an introduction to the Trendocs team. All right, enough of the introduction stuff. Let's jump into the latest with the Business Central release. Now, as a quick reminder, Business Central is an ERP solution built for the small and medium-sized organizations. It is a cloud solution that can easily and seamlessly connect all areas of your business from sales to service to finance and operations. Business Central allows your organization to adapt faster. With Business Central, you can innovate and adopt new business models faster with flexible deployment models, mobility, reliability, security, and adaptable Microsoft Cloud solutions that grow with your business. Business Central allows your organization to perform better and empowers people to be more collaborative and more productive and more impactful with actionable insights and interoperability to Microsoft 365, including Teams, Word, Excel, and Outlook. Business Central allows your organization to work smarter, enable your high performance with guided workflows, governance, real-time metrics that drive continuous process optimization, accelerate financial closes, and improve cycle times. With the latest release of Business Central, Microsoft has continued to invest in key areas like seamless service and performance with additional geographic expansion. They want to delight customers by exceeding expectations. Our investments in users' experience and rich capabilities ensure that we go beyond meeting customer expectations to deliver unexpected results. We want to drive better together Microsoft experiences. Microsoft wants to ensure that customers can benefit from using Office 365, Teams, Power Platform, and Business Central together to improve collaboration, productivity, workflow, insights, and results. Now, what we plan to review today are just a few of the many new features and added capabilities. For the full list of what's included in the release, you can go to docs.microsoft.com, find the Dynamics 365 release plan for Wave 1 2022, then navigate to the SMB section, and then click on Business Central, and you can review what's new and what's planned. Finally, some of these new features that are added with this release actually have to be enabled. Within Business Central, go to the search box, the search area, or the Tell Me area, and type Feature Management. You will then see a listing of new features, navigate to the Enable For column, and change any of those features to all users to turn that feature or enhancement on. All right, let's dive into a few and review some of these new features. First up is the ability to block the deletion of general ledger accounts. To help avoid accidental deletion of general ledger accounts, this release wave adds an extra check. To further safeguard accounts from accidentally being deleted, Microsoft added the block deletion of GL accounts toggle to the general ledger setup page. If you turn on the toggle, Business Central will prevent users from deleting accounts that have been entered after the date that's specified in the Check GL Account Deletion After field. Trendsoft recommends that you turn on the Block Deletion of GL Accounts toggle and that you always have a date set in the Check GL Account Deletion After field. Next up is the Auto Accept Transaction for Intercompany Journals. Intercompany postings make accounting for two or more companies an easier task for centralized finance departments, as well as bookkeepers and intercompany partner companies. We're adding automated general journal acceptance to remove several manual steps in the intercompany accounting process. New fields in the intercompany setup page mean that you can set up the companies for automatic creation of received intercompany transactions from intercompany partners. They are posted through to the intercompany general journal. In this release wave, we add a new intercompany setup page as well. The new feature must be enabled in the feature management page that we previously talked about. The next new feature is the ability to allow the sell to and bill to customers to be different on jobs. Going forward, when a project manager creates a job, they can specify the customer who will benefit from the project, and this customer can be different from the company that will pay for the project. Additionally, the project manager can specify the place where the work will happen by selecting from a list of ship-to addresses for the customer. The project manager can add information about external references to simplify communication about the project. They can overwrite the standard financial terms of specific projects as well. We also want to highlight the new check documents and journals while working feature. This is intended to alert you about issues from data in documents and journals that can prevent you from posting. Microsoft has introduced validations that identify issues right away. If your administrator enables this feature on the feature management page, Business Central will validate the data you enter on documents and journals while you work. If you choose enable this for me in the notification, the document check fact box will appear, and Business Central will start checking the document for issues while you enter information. The issue's total tile in the fact box shows the total number of issues that Business Central found. You can choose the tile to open an overview of those issues. If you want to stop using the document check, you can turn off the Show Document Checked Fact Box toggle on the My Notifications page. With this release, you can consolidate customer and vendor balances within Business Central. A company that you do business with might be both a customer and a vendor. So when that is the case, you can avoid making unnecessary payments or receipts and save on transaction fees by consolidating the customer and vendor balances. On the customer card, there's a new field called Balance by Vendor field. And on the vendor card, there's an included field called Balance as Customer field for companies that were created or linked to be the same company. On the payment journal page, you can use the Net Customer Vendor Balance action to net the customer and vendor balances for the company. The Net Customer Vendor Balance action creates a payment journal line to which the net balance for a customer and vendor are linked. Next up is the ability to find documents and entries efficiently. Finding related documents and entries is an existing capability of Business Central that you can use to track entries that are generated during the posting of specific transactions. The Find Entries feature has been available on most pages that display posted documents or document entries, but now it's also available on all role centers. You can easily access Find Entries feature by using the Control-Alt-Q short key combination anywhere in Business Central. You can use the Find Entries feature to search for context of a specific posted document, where it will show entries created for that document. You can also use it for broad searches, such as the following. You can search for documents using a posted document number or an external document number to find a specific posted or unposted document and related entry. You can search for business contacts related to documents or specific documents using an external document number. You can search for item references using serial or lot numbers to find all documents that are included for an item with those numbers. Pages for posted documents and ledger entries, such as posted sales invoices or customer ledger entry pages, show the general ledger entries related to a specific document or entry, even without using the Find Entries page. While this release, users now have more control over deferral postings. People use deferrals to recognize a revenue or an expense during a period that is different from the one in which the transaction was actually posted. The deferral functionality lets you automatically defer revenues and expenses over a specified schedule and multiple accounting periods, giving accountants more control over when people post deferrals. With this release, users can define periods during which you allow people to post deferrals for specific users on the GL setup page. For deferral templates, you can now have an option to specify beginning of next calendar year as the starting date. There's now a new user interface for demand forecasts. With any system, accurate demand forecasting gives businesses valuable insights into their position in the market, which helps decision makers shape their strategies for pricing, business growth, and market potential. Item variants are a great way to keep your list of items under control, especially if you have a large number of items that are almost identical and vary only in color. For example, rather than setting up each variant as a separate item, you can set up one item and then specify the various colors as variants on that item. With this 2022 Release 1 wave, you can define the right level of details in the forecast by location and forecast by variant fields in the Demand Forecast Overview page. Notice that filters by date, locations, items, as well as forecast types are stored in the Demand Forecast Name table, so you can easily stop and continue your work later. Existing customers must activate the new experience in this feature management page. Next up is the ability to set default dimensions on locations. Dimensions are values that categorize entries so that you can track and analyze them on documents such as sales orders. You can now set default dimensions for a location on the location card page by choosing location and then dimension. The location's default dimensions are copied to journals and documents when you specify the location on a line, but you can delete or change that dimension on the line if needed. You can require that people specify dimensions for specific locations before they can post an entry. Microsoft has added the ability to create bank deposits with this latest release. Bank deposits let you maintain a transaction record that contains information that can be applied to outstanding invoices and credit memos. By using bank deposits, you can easily view all transactions included in a deposit. Bank deposits also make bank reconciliation easier. The advantages of using deposits instead of general journal entries the preferred approach for registering deposits that cover more than one business transaction. The bank deposit page specifies the bank account deposited into, total deposits amount, posting date, document date, dimensions, and currency code, as well as the deposit lines. Deposit lines contain information about the individual deposited items, such as checks from the customer, cash sales revenues, or refunds from vendors. This information includes the document date, number, account type, and number, and amount. After you've entered this information about a deposit and add deposit lines, you must post the deposit to update the relevant ledger, such as the bank ledger, the general ledger, or the customer ledger. Find the bank deposits capabilities under cash management on the business manager and accountant role centers. You can also use the Tell Me to search for bank deposit page. Next up is a big one for our retail related clients, and that is the Shopify connector. Microsoft has teamed up with Shopify to help our customers create a better online shopping experience. Shopify provides merchants with easy to use e-commerce solution, and Business Central offers that comprehensive business management in a single application. Now, a seamless connection between these two systems will synchronize orders, stock, and customer information to ensure that the merchants can fulfill orders faster and better serve their customers. The joint effort furthers the commitment of Business Central to connect data to help businesses adapt faster, work smarter, and perform better. With Shopify, you can have multiple Shopify shops connected to the same Business Central environment. Each shop has its own setup, including a collection of products, locations used to calculate inventory, and price lists. There's also bi-directional synchronization of items and products. You can sync images, item variants, barcodes, vendor item numbers. You can extend text and tags. You can export item attributes to Shopify. You can use selected customer price groups and discounts to define price exported to Shopify. You can decide whether items can be created automatically or to only allow updates to existing products. The synchronization of inventory levels is available. You can choose some or all of the available locations in Business Central, and you can update inventory levels on multiple locations in Shopify. There's bi-directional synchronization of customers. You can smart map customers by phone and email, or you can use country-specific templates when creating customers, which helps ensure that their tax settings are correct. You can also import of orders from Shopify. You can create customers on the fly, or use fixed retail customer to keep customer data in Shopify. Included orders are created in other channels such as Shopify Point of Sale or Amazon. Shipping costs, gift cards, tips, shipping and payment methods, transactions, and risk of fraud are mitigated. You can also receive payment information from Shopify Payments and much, much more. Next up is the ability to release and reopen multiple documents. When you finish working on a batch of documents, you can release all or some of them in the next stage of the process or reopen them for further processing all in one go. To make it easier to quickly identify documents that are open or released, especially when viewing a list of documents, the open and release statuses have different font colors. When you release and reopen multiple documents, a confirmation page will show the number of documents that are selected, and that number will remain unchanged. Progress is shown during the process of releasing and reopening documents, and if there are errors, they are shown on the error messages page. With this latest release, there is now the ability to sync sales orders between Business Central and Dynamics 365 Sales. You can now synchronize sales orders between Business Central and Dynamics 365 Sales in both directions. For example, if a customer changes their mind about the product or quantity they order in sales, you can automatically process the change to the order in Business Central by archiving the sales document and creating a new one. The same is true for changes in Business Central. For example, when price, tax amounts, or expected shipment dates change, the changes are automatically synchronized to sales. This helps to keep your sellers up to date with the latest changes and the status of quotes and orders along the way. To enable the synchronization of sales orders in both directions, choose the bi-directional sync of sales orders field on either the Dynamics 365 Sales Settings page or in the setup of connection to Dynamics 365 Sales with the assisted setup. All right, the next several enhancements are all around streamlining the integrations with Microsoft Teams, Outlook, and OneDrive. First up is the Business Central app for Teams, which allows users to access business data and act on it directly from Microsoft Teams. Customers benefit from reduced context switching and collaboration efficiency when they can do more inside of Microsoft Teams. When pasting a link to Business Central in the Message Compose area in Teams, a banner is now automatically displayed that suggests installing the Business Central app so that a preview of the link can be shared as a compact, elegant card. This makes it easy for users to get the app with fewer steps. When the card is shared to a Teams channel, meeting, or group chat, the card includes a details button that displays the details window inside of Teams. This window now occupies more space on the screen and shows more fields and actions at once for greater efficiency. From the details window, you can now open the full Business Central experience in the browser. Next up is an Outlook enhancement. The email inbox often serves as a source of incoming files that initiate or unblock workflows, such as PDF invoices for payment, photos of damaged goods, customer requirements in a Word document, or part specifications listed in Excel. With the Business Central add-in for Outlook, you can remain in your flow of work and efficiently connect incoming files to business processes without ever leaving Outlook. Once you have identified the order that the email relates to, the attachment features can be used to copy files from the current email to that order. This next Outlook enhancement from Microsoft, they have added a pop-out window. Business users who work in Outlook can take advantage of the Business Central add-in. Normally, the contact insight sits neatly in a slim pane alongside the email. However, often users need more space. The Outlook add-in now provides a richer experience when opening a record in its own window. Most pages displayed in the Outlook add-in include an action to open the page in a new window that can be resized or docked out alongside Outlook. The next Office tool is an enhancement related to OneDrive. Microsoft has brought the best of Microsoft's business and productivity suites together to initiate collaborative review and sharing activities without having to leave Business Central. Users benefit from a familiar sharing experience and reduce the need to download files to their device. This makes it easy to share files from the report inbox and document attachments through OneDrive for Business. To share a report from the report inbox or to share an attachment to a record, you can now choose the share action. This action copies the file from Business Central to OneDrive for Business, then displays the file sharing dialog box in Business Central with numerous options. With this release, there are a couple of security and administrative changes to announce as well. First up, security administrators can define default permission set assignments when users sign up. The business value of this is that we've given Business Central security administrators improved control over who has access to what. The administrators can specify which permission sets or user groups are relevant for different product licenses and plans. Then, when someone signs up, they're automatically granted the permissions that the administrator specified for their license plan. You can access new license configuration from your administrators or user group or permission role centers. You can set user email policies to control who can read an email sent from Business Central. Administrators now have more control over who gets to see which emails by setting email view policies. From the user's list, you can now specify user email policies by choosing the related menu and then choosing the email view policy action. On the user email policy page, you can choose from the following options: view all emails, view only emails, view if access to all related records, and view if access to any related record. Finally, permission set handling enhancements. In 2022 release wave 1, admin users can leverage these permission sets and group them based on a tenant's needs. Visualize which permission sets are included in a given set, include others, and fine-tune them as needed. Microsoft also delivered a new capability to subtract permissions from a permission set scope in this release wave. This capability lets the admin specify that an object cannot be accessed. Business Central's integration with Power Automate has been enhanced with this release as well. For those who don't know, Power Automate empowers customers to create their own workflows using a low-code, no-code approach with a vast amount of connectors that make it easy to integrate systems. With this release, you can boost your business management system by customizing using Power Automate Instant Actions launched from any card page. You can run workflows of your choice and command Business Central to trigger actions based on Power Automate. For example, you can send an update via Teams or email, update the order status, notify your warehouse about change deliveries, etc. Note, this feature is not switched on by default, so an admin must go to the feature management page first to switch it on. Next up in this release are changes to the account schedules. As we all know, the presentation of financial reports is an important part of how people consume them. Reports must provide business insights in a way that enables people to easily recognize the report and quickly identify the important data. This release provides new capabilities for the account schedule that makes it easier for people to produce reports in the layout they desire. For example, you can control how the number 0 is printed, as in 0, dash, or blank. When skipping 0 lines, you can now keep headers, begin totals, and end totals in order to keep your schedule structures legible. When you define account schedules, you can use GL account categories as total filters for columns. The account schedules overview supports 15 columns, so you can view budgets for 12 months and a total. You can export and import account schedules to or from files, which makes it easier to reuse them between companies. Headings, beginning totals, are kept when printing to keep the structure of the account schedule. You can also choose to print lines marked as not to be shown, which makes validating the account schedules easier to do when you're designing them. Finally, one enhancement that is a little more technical is the ability to use Excel to design report layouts. Excel layouts work the same way as Word or RDLC layouts in that they can be edited and saved back again into Business Central. With Excel layouts for Business Central reports, users can now create and edit report layouts simply by using the full palette of capabilities in Excel, such as sliders, diagrams, charts, and pivot tables. To create an Excel layout from scratch, open the report request page and then run that report. The report generates an Excel file with sample data and the fields that are available in the report definition. Then you add your layouts to additional tabs within the Excel file. To test the layout, simply import it has a custom layout in Business Central, and after the system has validated that the layout is valid for use, you can now go into those request pages and run the report with your new layout. All right, well, I know that was a lot of information to take in and a lot of new features and added capabilities to discover. Let's take a few minutes here to address any questions that may have come in during the presentation. So we have had our team monitoring questions. If you have a question, absolutely please submit that into the Q&A.
And again, if you want a copy of these presentation slides or the video recording, just drop your email into the Q&A. We'll know exactly what that means. So we have had a couple of questions come in. One is related to the scheduling of upgrades specific to their tenant. And so if you are a Trendsoft client, we have scheduled that upgrade to be pushed out for you. And that should have been communicated to you. If you're unsure of when that date is, or you'd like to pick a different date, please just reach out to myself or to your Trendsoft contacts, and we'll get that either A, notify you when that date is, or we'll work with you to schedule it on a convenient date for you. Another question that has come in is related to third parties, any of those third party extensions that people have. You know, will upgrades or minor fixes that are pushed out break that? We as a Trendsoft partner do have access to the advance notice of these, and we try to work with the majority of these third parties. Some third parties, it's a non-event. Other third parties, there is a little bit of steps that need to be done where we might need to uninstall the third-party extension once the major release has been pushed out and then look to reinstall. We'll work with you on a case-by-case basis. But if you know of a third party that you're using, please work with our Trendsoft team. Notify us and let us look to see that against our list and kind of know, reach out to that third party. Be sure that nothing's going to break your environment. All right, I see some additional emails have come in of people requesting copies. Okay, it looks like one other question has come in just asking about kind of the cadence or the timing of releases with Business Central. So that is actually, there's two pieces to that. There is are your major releases, which is what we're talking about in this presentation. From Microsoft, there are two major releases a year, typically in April and October. And that's where, you know, there are just major, capabilities added, features added, enhancements, things change, et cetera. Microsoft does issue monthly what they call minor releases. So obviously 12 of those a year, and they are more minor, minor user interface changes, minor patches that are added, minor bug fixes, things that are done. So that is the cadence, two major releases a year from Microsoft and then monthly minor releases for the tenant. And typically with those minor ones, they're pushed out automatically, and your users don't even recognize from day to day when a minor release has been had. So, okay. All right, I don't see any other questions coming in. Again, if you have a question, absolutely submit that into the Q&A. We'll get that answered for you. If you think of a question afterwards that you kick yourself, why didn't I ask that? That's not a problem. You know, just reach out to myself or to Tara. We'll be happy to get that information sent to you. All right, a couple of next steps here as we wrap up. First up, for any of you who have completed this session, please be sure to complete that session evaluation prior to the end of the day Monday, as we will be doing some giveaways. And once you complete that, that evaluation, that will get you entered into that drawing. Secondly, if questions come up, like I just mentioned, reach out to us. We'll be happy to engage our technical team if needed. Be sure that you guys are using your system in the most efficient ways possible. Third, give us a follow on any of the social media platforms, on Twitter at Trendsoft. We're on Facebook, we're on LinkedIn. We're constantly pushing out updates, release information, webinars, good bits of information. So definitely give us a follow. And then finally, check out our website, trendsoft.com. We have a blog that is constantly churning out updates, good content there as well. Maybe something just to bookmark as a favorite on your browsing history. So, all right, just so a few things there for you guys to do. And like I said, if you guys have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to myself or to Tara Cox. We'll be happy to, sit down, set up a call with you, come and visit and talk about how best to use Business Central and any of the third-party extensions that are out there. With that, we thank everyone for their time, and we appreciate working with each of you, and we look forward to seeing where the future goes. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. Thank you.